They'd never show it and ruin the superhero mystique, but Robin's actually knee-deep in cigarette butts. Backseat's totally buried in an avalanche of losing scratch-off tickets and old Taco Bell bags.
Yep, Batman's riding high on one of those hemorrhoid donut pillows and a bottle of Pepto clamped tight between his thighs. Bumper sticker on the back reads, "If you don't like my driving, dial 1-800-EAT-GUANO.
Can the Wizard get firmer buns in 30 days? Stay tuned to find out.
And as Robin drives the armored car...
WP1, low on WTP, over.
Oh, great, we're late. No more yard sales, Neil. Robin's perfected this jump from years of Batman pushing him out of moving vehicles.
Hope the neutralizer hasn't been damaged.
The neutralizer, I'm feeling pretty indifferent about it.
Professor Hamill speaking.
Will you come down to my office, Professor?
Why should I?
Well, I'd like to ask your advice on a scientific matter.
I'm not explaining where babies come from again.
Oh, I'm Vicki Vale from Picture Magazine. I'd like to see Professor Hamill.
You can't, miss.
What did you just call me?
Professor Hamill, a photographer in the house.
You're strong.
This is urgent.
You can't, Chris.
What'd she call him?
Crouching flunky, hidden henchman.
Help!
I make you kiss. Mwah! Mwah!
I owe you a great deal, Batman, for saving my invention. The box is empty.
As empty as my gums.
Carter, you were the last one to handle this box.
I don't think there ever was anything in the box. It was too light. Besides, the seal wasn't broken when I brought it in here just now.
This isn't my original seal. It's a counterfeit. You or someone made
it. But probably you.
Professor, why did you trust such an important device to one man?
I had my reasons.
Maybe you wanted to have it stolen. I'm sorry, Professor.
I don't want to hear any of your apologies. Get out.
Yes, sir.
No, get out. Get out my wang and dip it in your cream corn.
That's it. I'm ordering that robot girlfriend kit.
This doorbell is by far the Wizard's most diabolical invention.
Here it is, sir.
So my plan worked.
My plan to get you all alone in my love cave. My lab.
I'll show you. I've been planning this for years. First, I'll put on this disc and tune it into both machines.
Next, Chuck D and I get signed to Def Jam.
If BlackBerry designed Google Glass.
Gotham High Locker Room, here I come!
You hear me, Neil?
Yeah, but I can't see you.
That's because I'm invisible.
The Wizard, master of camouflage and condescension.
Why does he talk down to me so? He'd never do that to his beloved Gabe.
Now I can finally track down that elusive Robert Denby. Bat signal powered by Light Bright with 3 pegs remaining.
Oh, good. Staring into the sun for hours on end has finally reaped its reward.
Can't believe you dropped both our masks in the toilet, Robin.
Do you think that threat should be taken seriously?
With Batman's track record? Yes!
Batman feels differently about it. I believe the Wizard plans a surprise attack.
But how?
That's what we're here to find out. Where are the plans for the super jet plane?
In that vault.
Then my guess is he's going to try to get into that vault.
This whole thing might be a trick to make us move.
1 minute till 3.
He's right! The master detective nails it again!
What's the idea of pulling my coat?
Inhaler, empty, bladder, full.
Maybe we're all getting jumpy around here.
Or grab-assy.
Okay, rule number one on a mission, never leave Robin alone with something that shines, rolls, or beeps.
And our intrepid boy wonder is taken out with a lobbed Scrabble tile rack.
With his trap set, the Wizard gleefully moonwalks out the door.
He died voguing.
Watch working fine, suck it, Coily.
The vinegar mixed with the baking soda!
What is the meaning of this murderous attack on Carter?
He forgot the FiberCon.
Strike next. Don't fail to see Batman vs. Wizard, Chapter 14 of Batman and Robin, at this theater next week.
How was your trip to Mars?
What trip?
You went to recall, remember?
I did?
Hey, you did.
What are you? My father.
What the fuck did I do wrong? What the fuck did I do wrong?
You black queen! You black about Mars!
Are you crazy? I don't even know anything about Mars!
What the fuck did I do wrong?
You should have listened to me, Quaid. I was there to keep you out of trouble.
Harry, you're making a big mistake. You got me mixed up with somebody else.
Pal. You got yourself mixed up with somebody else.
You brought your future vessels on the planet.
Party Richter! How was your trip to Mars?
I was sure we parked around here somewhere, Robin.
Oh, I have to pee.
Ah, there it is.
Oh, no, just another black sedan.
But they're all black sedans, Teen Wonder. Acres of them. Damn flea market parking lots. How will we ever... Oh, thank heavens. Batmobile away!
Oh, Batman, I'm not sure this is the Batmobile. The radio presets are Christian rock. The license plate says juicy. And I'm sitting on a hemorrhoid pillow, but it's not my usual hemorrhoid pillow.
Ah.
Mine has a picture of your face on it.
Ah, wait, I didn't sign off on those.
Yeah, it's a bootleg. I got it when I went to Bangkok. I'm surprisingly popular in certain circles over there.
Please stop talking, Robin.
What you are witnessing is real. The participants are not actors. They are actual litigants with a case pending.
The Macarena starts. Arm out, palm down, Callahan. You're off the force!
The wizard's pot roast is nearly done.
He also packs the bat Febreze and the bat dryer sheets inside a bat cardboard tube.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kiss!
Gonna rock and roll all night!
I thought that blast had finished you.
It would have if I hadn't stepped into the inner chamber to use my oxygen inhaler.
Howard Hughes keeps his urine in there. It's wild.
I don't know.
You know who this crap wouldn't be happening to?
Gabe?
Gabe. Or Dan.
It's true.
I sense that I'm visible.
I'm no more the wizard than you are, Gordon.
Is this the man you were chasing?
Well, it could be if you wore a cloak.
Yeah, but that would also be true of literally anyone.
Now, if the beams from each machine crossed each other, what would happen to an object they focused on?
Total protonic reversal, duh.
The object would become invisible to the human eye.
You see? The wizard has both machines and can make himself invisible at certain times.
Usually for a dine and dash.
I'd still like to know where you're getting your information on the wizard's activities.
Inside tips. They cost me plenty.
You ever canoodled with Mr. Freeze, Gordon?
Take them off.
Oh, it's not good.
Well, if you insist.
What happened to your right hand? This?
A little run-in with the Benny Jesserit. I'm the Kwisatz Haderach Flatfoot.
Anything else you'd like to know?
Plenty, and I'm going to find it out, too. Yes?
That report on the Mills case is ready.
I'll be right over. It's all for now, Brown.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll leave you unsupervised in my office again, which I'm sure will be just fine.
Time to audit the commissioner's thetan levels.
Gotham's top cop right there, folks.
It's as I feared. My bat sperm are few and sluggish.
This job would be so much easier if I could read.
Commissioner Gordon speaking. This is Batman. I've identified the fingerprints of the glove.
You have? Whose are they?
Carter's.
Nell Carter's.
Are you sure?
No doubt of it.
Let's get out to Professor Hamill's place right away. Batman and Robin are moving in on the wizard.
Sorry, that's moving in with the wizard. Grab a sleeping bag, Robin. Things are gonna get wacky.
Commissioner Gordon has identified the fingerprints of the criminal known as the wizard. Gordon is on his way at this moment to the home of a prominent scientist to make an arrest.
How did he know that?
I'll deal with Brown after I arrest Carter.
Anyone worried we're now speeding towards our death?
I know why you're here. You think I've failed. But I can still help you. Don't shoot! Please don't shoot!
Aw, and he just had that goon smock freshly laundered.
They wanted to be stealthy, so they pulled up to the front of the house.
He's dead. He's been murdered.
Who's murdered?
I lost my floor vision long ago.
Didn't you hear any shots?
No, I was in the garden. Why would anyone want to shoot him?
Says the man who was furious with him all the time.
That's ridiculous. Impossible.
His fingerprints prove otherwise.
I'll never believe it.
How'd you hurt your hand, Professor?
I burned it in the laboratory.
They are wrong in thinking the wizard is dead. He is very much alive, and he threatens the life of Commissioner Gordon at 2 o'clock this afternoon in Gordon's own office.
I didn't call Gordon directly because I really don't care. Seriousness.
The wizard is a desperate criminal who has the ability to make himself invisible.
And to turn a lot of knobs.
I am about to reveal the wizard's true identity. He is...
That is one hard to pronounce name.
Ladies and gentlemen, Barry Brown will be unable to continue this broadcast due to a mysterious accident.
Good instinct. Announce it on the radio before calling an ambulance.
My Klieg light brings all the best to the yard, and my light is better than yours.
Well, I still don't know what kind of a picture I'm to take.
I don't either, but when you do, I want you to use this bulb.
He's got an assortment of light bulbs back there.
Adam West and Burt Ward in a shocking cameo?
Every four-year-old in the audience is shouting, really?
Look! Now, how would looking have helped?
Is there no way to control this invisible menace? What new danger confronts Vicky?
Did she ever go to her brother's funeral?
See Batman Victorious, the final chapter of Batman and Robin, at this theater next week.
Major spoiler alert in the title of the exciting conclusion.
Howdy, stranger. This is Hauser. If things have gone wrong, I'm talking to myself, and you've got a wet towel wrapped around your head.
Sneak in the flowers and look innocent. With the flowers. Ice cold showers with the flowers.
When this is over, I shall hang up my flannel cape and cowl, well, shove them into the file cabinet, and live out my days as a simple billionaire playboy. You, on the other hand, will become a ward of the state after I transfer custody over to the Gotham City orphanage.
So wait, couldn't I still fight crime as the boy wonder?
Try it and I'll sue the ill-fitting tights off you.
Based on past chapter titles, I bet he ends up bloodied, shamed, and destitute.
Commissioner Gordon calls on Batman and Robin for aid.
Like a little bitch.
They meet in his office, and as the appointed hour approaches...
Hey, an automatic fart diffuser. Nice.
Yeah, this feels like a better fit to me.
It's 2:00.
And that affects me how?
And our hero's dearly killed with his back to a window after just being reminded of points of entry.
Tell the commissioner we found a car.
And that we're leaving it unguarded.
Yeah? Good work. One of the wizard's men has been picked up in a car a block from here.
Then the wizard will be without transportation.
We still won't be able to see him.
Do you think the wizard is a 90-year-old woman with cataracts? Invisible Superman is changing in there.
You'll do as I say.
Find me the address of a girl's locker room.
Hurry.
Okay.
See through you later.
Why don't we go?
We can't do any more than the police are doing right now.
That's the vigilante spirit.
Here's your invisible man.
Good work, Vicky.
Who is it?
Carter?
Well, he's dead.
Well, it's still Carter.
Well, how can that be?
I have an idea.
Find out why he took off his mask for once.
Sure.
How Apple wants you to see your year-old iPhone.
Meet the car there. That's all. I must go.
That's how I sign off when I call into Art Bell.
Oh yeah, this is much more discreet than simply walking to the rendezvous point.
Or sneaking onto a bus. Or hiding in the backseat of a car already headed in that direction.
And just to be clear, he's driving a car while invisible to a place where he ordered a car to pick him up because doing so in the city would be too conspicuous.
Right.
Somebody took our car.
We suspect sinister villain, the valet.
Fingerprints were taken. Roadblocks are being set up ahead of it.
Good. That'll give Robin more time.
Though that could work against us.
Oh, I can't tell if I'm at 10 or 2 or 9 or 3, and I don't know what's going on!
Oh, God. Steering column through invisible chest! Invisible blood everywhere!
Moby's first attempt at sampling.
Here we are now, going through the rest of...
Look at all these grass stains!
The invisible man broke through the roadblock but has abandoned his car.
Our car. Boy, I'm gonna miss this field. A lot of stupid crap involving idiots happened here.
Are you alright?
Yes.
Where's Robin?
I followed him here.
I guess that. Where is he now?
He took the path toward the cliff. Untie me, please.
I haven't got time. You'll be all right. Don't go away.
The window's rolled down. You're fine. Parkour!
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 Parkour! Ow, my knee!
Batman!
They're really going all out with the special effects for this finale, aren't they?
Man, you got me cornered at last.
Are you admitting that you're the wizard, Professor?
Yes, I'm ready to make a full confession.
I stole these shoulder pads from Joan Collins.
My twin brother and I merely took orders from Professor Hamill.
Then it was your twin brother who was killed.
That's right, by Hamill.
Yes, I did it after arranging things so that you would think the wizard was dead.
It's my duty to take you to police headquarters. You, Carter, are the wizard. You forced Hamill to make that confession by threatening his life.
That's right.
Commissioner Gordon wants to see you.
He's not mad, just very disappointed.
Then Professor Hamill didn't know that Carter had a twin brother?
No. While the brother was acting as Hamill's attendant, Carter was carrying on as the wizard.
And maybe Kaiser Soze, I don't know.
I'm going to have dinner with Bruce Wayne. Will you join us?
That's very nice of you.
Then you'll come?
Of course.
Robin's like, I like dinner.
Barry Brown get the information he broadcast?
From the wizard. I think he was using Brown without his knowledge.
Yes, but how did he do that? Oh, okay, I guess we're moving on.
Pardon me, please.
I'll call you later, Robin, since we're not invited to dinner.
Who answers other people's phones?
Hello?
Is Miss Dale there?
Just a moment. It's for you.
Hello?
Vicky, I'm sorry. I can't keep our date.
Tee-hee, tee-hee.
I'll be in town for a week.
You understand, don't you?
Oh, of course, Bruce. You must be completely worn out.
Turn record over.
Wait, what's that?
You know, I thought I had discovered your identity, but I just found out I was wrong.
Really? What did you think I was?
Bruce Wayne. Wasn't that silly?
Yes, wasn't it?
I blame you for my brother's death.
And they all lived gably ever after.